Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Love Starter. In this video, you'll learn 9 common AdWords mistakes that you need to avoid when managing your account and your campaigns. This video follows on from my original biggest AdWords mistakes video. By avoiding these AdWords mistakes, you'll optimize the performance of your campaigns and their results. And even if you don't have time to apply all of the tips to your own campaigns today, even a small change can have a positive impact on the performance of your account. And here's a quick disclaimer. Although these are common mistakes, we will be covering some more advanced options available inside Google AdWords. So if you are just getting started, then check out my links to my beginner resources in the description below this video. Now let's jump in and cover the 9 common AdWords mistakes. You'll be rocking AdWords in no time. Mistake number 1 is forgetting ad extensions. Ad extensions allow you to enhance your ads by adding additional information and functionality. For example, you can use site link ad extensions to include additional links with your ads. This gives people additional opportunities to click through to your website from your ads. Apart from additional links, you can also include your phone number, address details, include products and services, and more. It can be easy to overlook ad extensions, so that's why it's mistake number 1. And don't forget to review your existing ad extensions when you're optimizing your account, campaigns, and ad groups. You want to improve them just like you would your ad variations. For details on all the different types of ad extensions, check out the resources in the description below this video. Mistake number 2 is duplicate keywords. If you have a keyword in multiple ad groups, then you might be increasing the amount you spend. For example, if you have a keyword in one ad group with a bid of $2, and then that keyword is duplicated in another ad group with a bid of $4, then it's likely that the higher bid will be used to display your ads. This means you could be spending more than you realize on clicks. Now, there are times when there might be a good reason to have a keyword duplicated in your account. For example, if the keyword is in a campaign that uses different geographic targets, this is perfectly okay since the keyword will not be competing against one another. Mistake number 3 is not using remarketing. Even if you're not running display campaigns, it's important to set up remarketing audience lists for people who've been to your website. This allows you to target your ads and adjust your bids to people if they're included in an audience list. For example, using remarketing with your search campaigns allows you to increase your bids if someone has been to your website but hasn't converted yet. This allows you to increase your bids for competitive keywords to increase your visibility. And of course, remarketing is also the perfect way to start advertising on the Google Display Network. By targeting people who've already engaged with your website and brand, you're more likely to drive conversions from your display campaigns. Mistake number 4 is skipping bid adjustments. If you're not using bid adjustments with your campaigns, then you might not be maximizing the results from your campaigns. Think of bid adjustments as a way to define the sweet spots for your campaigns. Use them as a way to ensure your ads are seen by the right people at the right time. Bid adjustments allow to increase or decrease your bids based on a person's geographic location, the device they're using, and the time and day of week. For example, if you know that people located in Vancouver using mobile devices between 10 a.m. and 12 p.m. on a weekday are more likely to convert, then you can use this to increase your bids to ensure your ads are visible based on the insights from your analytics. Mistake number 5 is not grouping keywords. It's important to use good keyword grouping for your search campaigns. This allows to show really targeted ads based on the keywords contained in the ad group. A good guide is to check that each of your ad groups contain a maximum of 5 to 10 keywords each. If there are more keywords than that in an ad group, it can indicate that they're not as closely related as they could be. When keywords aren't closely related, it means that you have to have a more generic or general ad to show along with those keywords, which means the results aren't going to be as strong from your campaign. You might even find that you have a handful of really important keywords. If you have a keyword that is important and that you're investing heavily in, then you might want to even consider putting it in its own dedicated ad group so that you can ensure that you have the best possible ads showing for the term. Mistake number 6 is drawing conclusions too quickly. This can actually relate to a few different areas when it comes to managing your account. Maybe you've launched a new campaign, testing a landing page, or maybe you're running an AdWords experiment. Whenever you're trying something new or testing, it's important to make sure there is enough data available before making a decision and taking action. It can be tempting to jump to a conclusion based on the initial results, but this can be a mistake, since you might find the results change once you've waited 2 or 3 weeks. By waiting, you'll be collecting more information, which provides more reliable results for you to take action on in your account. So try not to jump to a conclusion too fast. Mistake number 7 is not optimizing your landing pages for conversions. There are different ways that you can optimize your landing pages for your AdWords campaigns, but one of the best ways to improve your results is to run conversion tests. This is where you create a new version of your landing page and send some traffic to the new version and some traffic to the existing version, and then review the results. By improving your landing pages, you'll also be improving the performance of your campaigns and increasing the ROI from AdWords. A great way to run conversion tests on your website is to use Google Optimize. You can find a link to my Getting Started tutorial in the description below this video. Mistake number 8 is not linking Google Analytics or Google Search Console to AdWords. By linking products, you'll have a better understanding of how your campaigns perform. When you link Google Analytics, it means you can understand how people engage with your website after clicking on your ads. You can see where they travel to and how engaged they are. You can even pull some basic metrics like bounce rate from Google Analytics back into your Google AdWords account. To do this, just click on Configuration, then Linked Accounts, select Google Analytics, then select your analytics property and enable the option for Import Site Metrics. And by linking Google Search Console, you'll be able to compare the performance of your paid and organic results right within Google AdWords. Mistake number 9 is targeting search and display in the same campaign. This is where you create a search campaign and select the option for display expansion. It means the campaign can show ads on both the Google Search Network and the Google Display Network. Now, AdWords is likely to spend most of your budget showing your ads on search, but overall, you will achieve better results if you create separate search and display campaigns. It gives you more control and makes reporting easier. So although you can combine targeting in a single campaign, it's not recommended. So they're the 9 common AdWords mistakes that you need to avoid when managing your campaigns and account. If you don't have time to apply all of these tips today, don't worry, even applying a few of these tips will help improve your campaigns. You'll find that even taking small steps to optimize your campaigns can provide measurable results. And here's an extra tip. When you run a search campaign, always consider the relationship between the keyword you're targeting, the ads that you're displaying, and the landing pages that you're sending people to. The better the relationship between these 3 elements, the better the performance of your campaigns. By considering each of these elements every time you create and manage your campaigns, you'll be considering the complete experience for someone searching and ensure that your campaigns are a success. So what's stopping you? Load up your account if you haven't already and put a big tick next to each of these common pitfalls and rock your account. You can and will succeed at getting the clicks and conversions that you're aiming for. Do you have any tips you'd like to add? Let me know in the comments below. And take a moment to subscribe to my channel to receive the latest tips, tutorials, and more. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.